Hi, this video is about YouTube InfoCard's 10 best practices. Did you know that 50% of views to YouTube come from mobile devices? YouTube InfoCards allow clickable links across both mobile and desktop devices. This means you can increase the number of people that interact with your videos.
Herman Drost, DrostDesigns.com.
Here are the 10 best practices for YouTube InfoCards. Number 1. Make sure your cards are related to your target audience. They should be interesting, relevant, and engaging, otherwise nobody is going to click on them. Number 2. Use only 1 to 3 cards max. Even though you can use a maximum of 5 cards, fewer cards will generate more clicks. Number 3. Spread out multiple cards on your timeline. People won't click on your cards if they're all bunched together. Space them out along your timeline at different intervals. Look inside your engagement reports within YouTube Analytics to determine when people stop watching your videos. Then add a card there to increase engagement. Number 4. View your cards reports. Look inside YouTube Analytics to measure the performance of your cards. Determine which ones receive the highest click-through rates, and the ones that don't, you can get rid of. Number 5. Don't point at the card in your video. Cards will display in different locations in your video depending on the device that your viewer is using. Number 6. Make sure your YouTube account is in good standing. If you want to link your card to an associated website, then your YouTube account must have no copyright or community guidelines violations. Number 7. Featured videos won't appear when using cards. Choose whether a featured video or card will work best for your targeted audience. Number 8. Continue to use end cards. Your viewers may not know they have to click on the card in order to view them. Therefore, use annotations for your end cards so you can direct viewers to related videos. Number 9. Upload a card image size of 500 by 500 pixels. You can also select one of the suggested images. I find that this image size is a good place to start. YouTube will always scale it down so it will display correctly. Number 10, change your cards at any time. The beauty of YouTube InfoCards is that you can change the URL or image at any time. If you find your card is not performing well for a previously uploaded video, you can swap out the URL or image. That's it, now you know the 10 best practices for YouTube InfoCards. Click this image to download my free report, YouTube Editing Secrets. Learn the shortcut to video editing on YouTube that doesn't require expensive software. Click this image to download it now or click the link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching.